Hi everyone, this is Daryl Legacy, Instructional Designer at HAC. If you have concerns about giving quizzes fully online, I hope this will help. In this video, I'm going to give you a couple quick tips for making it harder for students to look up the answers to your online quiz. For this video, I will mostly be focusing on short questions, like true-false, multiple-choice, and matching, but these tips would actually work equally well for more difficult questions. First, I have to say that it is nearly impossible to completely stop students from looking up any of the questions, but we can make it a little more difficult. The first step is to introduce a tight timing restriction. After you have made all the questions for your quiz, go back to the Edit Quiz page. Then, click on the Restrictions tab. Scroll down to the Timing section. This is how long the students have to complete the quiz once they start. You'll notice that the default is set to Recommended Time Limit and 120 minutes. We're going to click the Enforced Time Limit button instead. The amount of time you allow the students is up to you. However, I recommend a fairly tight time limit so that students won't be able to look up every question. For simple true-false or multiple choice, that might be 1 minute per question or less. My quiz only has 3 questions, a true-false, a matching, and a multiple choice, so I'm going to limit the students to 3 minutes. The grace period is the amount of time that students have to finish up and submit their quiz after the regular time limit is up. It will warn them that they are almost out of time. No matter how long the time limit is, I recommend keeping the grace period to just 1 or 2 minutes. I'm going to set mine to 1 minute. That gives them only 4 minutes total to complete the quiz, which is very reasonable for 3 simple questions. Now, you need to decide what happens if the student exceeds the time limit and the grace period. The first option lets them keep working, which will make our time limit pretty meaningless. The second option stops the student from being able to answer any more questions, though they do still need to click the Submit button. The third option gives the student a 0 if they exceed both the time limit and grace period. For most quizzes, the second option will work fine. Now, scroll back up and click on the Properties tag again. There's one more strategy we can use to prevent students from looking up all the answers. Scroll down to the area just above where you can add or edit questions. There is a box titled Questions per Page. This determines how many quiz questions appear on each page. If you leave it blank, the default is to show all the questions together on one long page. This allows students to go back and forth to earlier and later questions as much as they want. For some quizzes, like long answer or open book quizzes, this default option may make sense. But for this quiz, let's put just 1 question per page. Then, click the box next to Paging that says Prevent students from moving backwards through pages. This means that students will now see just 1 question at a time, and they cannot go back to look at or answer previous questions. Make sure to click the Apply button after you type the number per page. You will see that now there are blue lines between every question to show that each is its own page. With a short time limit and no ability to know which questions are still coming up, they can only guess about which questions they may need to look up. With 4 minutes for a 3-question quiz, they may have enough time to look up 1 question. However, when they see question 1, they don't know if that is harder or easier than the other questions still to come. What if they spend 2 minutes looking up the first question, only to find that question 2 is actually harder? This will make it very difficult for them to look up all the hard questions. While we are here, let's click the button below that says Shuffle Questions at the Quiz Level. This option will place the questions in a random order so that students won't all see question 1 first and question 3 last. This makes it harder for students to share information about specific quiz questions. Lastly, if you have multiple choice questions in the quiz, there is one more thing we can do. Click on Add Edit Questions. Then click on a multiple choice question if you have one. After the answer choices, you will see a box that says Randomize answers for each student. This will place the answer choices in random order for every student. One word of caution, do not randomize the choices if any of them are, quote, all of the above or none of the above. Doing this could result in some confusing situations where all of the above is the first or second answer choice for some students. By randomizing the order of the questions and of the answers, it means a student cannot tell a classmate that the quiz answers are A, A, C in order, because the other student's order will be different. It also may help students who are anxious when the answer order does not feel random enough to them, or if they just choose C whenever they don't know it. These three strategies of randomizing question and answer order, making strict time limits, and preventing them from going backwards can help to ensure academic integrity. While you can't prevent students from ever looking up a question, you can make it much harder for them to find the answer to more than a small percentage of them. I hope you find this video helpful, and I will be making some future videos with more strategies to make your online assignments more secure. That's it for this video, but if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me or any of my colleagues in the CDI team.